Hello students, welcome to the English class. Today's class, let us learn Unit 5, The Wonder Bowl. Let us learn the new words that you come across in this lesson. Mound is a raised land. Hooted is shouted. Ill-treat is show discourtesy. Ragged is dresses in torn clothes. Hospitality is friendly reception of guests. How you treat your guests, that is called as hospitality. Mansion is a big house or a palace. Astonished is wondered. Main characters that you come across in the story is Philemon and Baucis. They are the old couple, husband and wife. You have village boys to be seen and two strangers who enter the story as strangers, and by the end of the story they are recognized as angels. Small introduction to the chapter. You can see the picture in your textbook, children, page number 74. This is full story based on Mahabharata. Pleased with Yudhishthira's prayers, Lord Surya gave him the Akshaya Patra. Yudhishthira was given that Akshaya Patra. Patra is a bowl. Akshaya Patra to Yudhishthira. Pleased with the prayers of Yudhishthira, Lord Surya, the sun god, had given him Akshaya Patra. What was the use of Akshaya Patra? It would give unlimited food until Draupadi finished her meal. Draupadi was the wife of the five Pandava brothers. The Pandavas used this during their exile. When they were in the forest, they used this bowl for them. It so happened that Durvasa and his disciples arrived at Yudhishthira's dwelling. One day, sage Durvasa visited the place where Yudhishthira and his brothers stayed. Durvasa asked Yudhishthira to arrange food for him and his disciples. But what had happened? Yudhishthira was unable to arrange because there was no food left to serve them, since Draupadi had already finished her lunch. The Pandavas became anxious. The sage and his disciples who were bathing in the river would return for food soon. Now, what was it that they could do? Because it was said that Durvasa was known for his anger, and if he would curse, anything could happen. Now, Draupadi prayed to Lord Krishna for help. Krishna appeared and asked Draupadi to bring the Akshaya Patra. So finally, Draupadi went in surrender of praying to Krishna, Lord Krishna, and suddenly a Krishna appeared and asked Draupadi to get that Akshaya Patra. On looking closely at the bowl, Krishna found a single grain of rice and he ate it. Looking at the bowl, there was only one grain of rice left over. He was satisfied with the meal. His satisfaction in turn made Durvasa and his disciples feel so fully fed that they never came to Yudhishthira's house. As soon as Krishna ate that one grain of rice, all the disciples of Durvasa and his disciples, they were feeling that their stomach was filled and they never came back to Yudhishthira's house to have their food. The previous introduction to the lesson, in that story, it shows that the good people will finally be having a good result in whatever work they do. Now we'll proceed with the chapter, The Wonder Bowl. Let's see what the story, The Wonder Bowl, has to say. So in the first stanza, there lived an old couple named Philemon and Baucis in a small hut on a mound. Mound is a raised ground, like of mud, in a higher place a little. They worked hard in their farm and were only able to get as much as food as they needed. And what was their earning? Their earning was only a little for them to fill their stomach. Yet they were so kind that they would never let any stranger who came to their doors go without food. Though they earned very little, whomever stranger visited their house, they would serve them a little food. They welcomed the guest with joy and shared their own meal with him. Whichever guest came to their house, this couple used to share their own meal with them. One evening, they finished their supper and sat at the door. An evening, they had finished their dinner and they were sitting at the door. Suddenly, they heard the barking of dogs and shouting of boys in the village. They could hear the dogs barking far away and the boys shouting. Soon, the noise grew louder. Philemon saw two strangers at whom the village boys hooted and the dogs barked. What does the husband see? Philemon sees that there were two strangers at whom the village boys were hooting, just shouting at them, and the dogs were barking. Philemon said to his wife, "Look at these boys. They ill-treat the poor strangers. I shall go and bring them. You go and see if there is any food to give." Now, as known, they were the kind couple. So Philemon says to his wife, "Look at those boys. They are ill-treating. They are badly treating the poor strangers." So he would go and bring them. And he asked his wife to get inside and see if there was any food for them to serve. Philemon went down to meet the ragged newcomers. He drove back the dogs and said, "Welcome, strangers." He took them into his poor cottage and made them sit at the table. They looked very tired. So what did Philemon do? He went down to meet the ragged newcomers. The people who had come were wearing torn clothes. Ragged is torn clothes. And he drove the, they were newcomers to the village. And Philemon drove the dogs and said, "Welcome, strangers." He welcomed them to his poor cottage, that's a small house, and made them sit at the table. And those people looked very tired. Now, Bosses placed a small bowl of milk on the table and said, "This is all that I have for you, sirs. How I wish you had come a little earlier. We would have shared our supper with you." Now, here comes his wife, Philemon's wife, Bosses. She places a small bowl of milk on the table and says that, "This is all left over after we had the supper. If you had come a little early, they could have shared their supper with those people." "Don't worry, good lady," said one of the guests. "All will be well. Your kindness makes this drink a feast to us. We are pleased with your hospitality." So one of the stranger or one of the guests who had come to their house says that not to worry and everything would be good. So their kindness, the kindness of the couple, makes that drink a feast. Like, it is not just a bowl of milk, it's like feasting. So they are pleased with their hospitality. The guests were pleased with the hospitality because the way the couple treated the strangers. Bosses poured the milk from bowl into two cups and placed them before the guests. They drank the milk and later one of them asked for some more. So Bosses poured a little milk from the bowl to two cups and placed before the guests. They drank the milk and later one of them asked for some more. They wanted little more. Bosses was in confusion. He said, "Sorry, my dear guests, there is hardly a drop left in this bowl." "Why?" cried the guest, taking the bowl. "There is milk in this bowl as much as we want." So saying, he filled not only his cup, but also his friend's. Bosses was astonished. Now, what happened? So there was only little milk, so Bosses had filled it into the two cups. The guests had already drank and one of them wanted still more. But Bosses was confused because she had already mentioned that that was the only thing left in their house. By then the guest cried, "Why?" And then they said that there is still milk in the bowl. So saying, what happened? That person, the stranger or the guest who had come, he filled not only his cup but also his friend's. So there was ample of milk in that bowl to fill in two cups. Looking at this, Bosses was very astonished, surprised to see, wondered what is happening because the bowl was almost empty as the guests filled their cups again from the bowl. She could hardly believe her eyes. "They are not ordinary men," whispered Bosses to her husband. "Yes," he replied, "they must be angels from heaven come to bless us." So now looking at the action of the stranger, Bosses could hardly believe her eyes. She could never believe. Then she decided that they are not ordinary men. But I also whispered to her husband. She said slowly to her husband, "Yes, they might be angels who had come from heaven to bless them." "Good mother," said the guest, "we thank you for your kindness. May your bowl be full of milk always." So the strangers who had come home in the form of guests, they said, "Good mother." And they also thanked for the kindness and they also wished that, "May your bowl be full of milk always. May the bowl, what you have or what you eat, will be full of milk always." That doesn't mean the bowl will be always filled with milk. It means that they would have the meals for whatever they wanted to have all the time. Then they went to bed. Philemon and Bosses could hardly sleep because of the wonder that the strangers had worked with the bowl. The guests arose early next morning and got ready to go. Philemon and Bosses walked out with them for a short distance. "Good Philemon and Bosses," said one of the guests, "we are God's messengers. We are much pleased with your kindness. Ask for anything you like, you shall have it. So, here now, after they had their milk, they went to bed. And both the couple couldn't sleep. They hardly got sleep because of the wonder that the strangers had worked with the bowl. What was the wonder they had created? Though the milk was empty in the bowl, they had filled their cups with the milk. Now the guests arose early, very next day morning, they got ready to go. And the couple walked with them for a short distance. So they said, good Philemon and Baucis, that it's time to leave. And finally they revealed their secret that they were God's messengers. They were pleased with their kindness. Ask for anything and you would have. And the God's messengers blessed the couple, saying that they could ask for a boon. The old couple looked at each other. After a moment, Philemon said, good angels, we wish to die together. Be it so, replied the angels. There is your home. Live in it as long as you desire and come to heaven together. So, pleased with the hospitality of the couple, the God's messengers said they would be blessed with a boon. Thinking for a moment, Philemon said that they would wish to die together. The couple would preferably want to die together. And the angels blessed them. Let your wish be fulfilled. And they said that there is a home. Live in that as long as you desire. And come to heaven together later after their death. Old Philemon and Baucis were astonished to see their poor cottage turn to a grand mansion. When they turned round to thank the angels, they saw nobody there. They humbly prayed to God and lived in their mansion, doing good to everyone. So this couple, when they turned back and saw, they were astonished to see, they wondered to see that the very small poor cottage which they were living now had turned into a grand mansion, means a very big palace like house. When they turned round to see where the angels were, they were not seen anywhere around. So what these couple did, they humbly prayed to God and lived in their mansion, doing good to everyone. With their poverty itself, they used to help the strangers who had come to their house, even providing them whatever they had to eat. And now, when they were blessed with the grand mansion, they also did good to everyone. So here, there's a message that when you do good to others, you will be repaid with the good things always.